Saturn transit in Capricorn from the 23rd of May 2021 till the 11th of October 2021 for a period of 141 days in the nakshatra of moon, which is Ravana nakshatra. What is the effect of this transit? How is it going to influence all of us? And what is retrogression? And what is the big fuss about this Saturn getting retrograde this time especially? So hey guys, what's up? I hope you guys are doing great, and I welcome you back to Purab's Astrology. And I am shooting this video, it is around 8 p.m. in the night here, and Saturn has already become retrograde around 2:53 p.m. in my location. And I thought that I need to absorb the energy of this retrograde Saturn and only then make this transit video, because only then I can do justice to this video. And especially because Saturn is placed in my horoscope in the 10th house in the sign of Capricorn, and it is retrograde as well. So it is a mammoth event which is happening in my life and also the lives of many people. So let's not hype much further and let's deal with Saturn retrograde. So first, what is a retrograde planet? A retrograde planet is a planet which moves backward. But technically and scientifically, a planet can never go backward. But from the Earth, this planet becomes closer and it appears to be moving in backward direction. But it is not actually moving in backward direction. But the effects are such that the planet becomes more powerful, the effect and its influence become more, because it is very close to Earth and the influence of that planet is more upon us. Now, during this transit of Saturn in the sign of Capricorn, between the 23rd of May till the 11th of October for 141 days, there will be a lot of impact in the mental level, because Saturn is actually hitting the energy of Moon. It is placed in the nakshatra of Moon, which is Ravana. So we all will be feeling a lot of sorrow and anxiety in this time period, because Saturn's energy is getting injected into the nakshatra of Moon. So Moon is going to get influenced and affected by Saturn, and this is going to be felt by everybody across the globe, human beings, animals, worms and everything, because Saturn's influence is everywhere, guys. Where there is time, there is Saturn. So Saturn is the jury and Saturn is the executioner, and we need to be very careful with our actions, because when the planet Saturn is getting retrograde and it is going back into its own sign of Capricorn, it is time to revisit and review the decisions and review the actions which we have done and take the right decisions. So during this period, don't do anything unlawful. Follow the rules. Don't hurt people who are undernourished, under poverty, underprivileged and poor, because Saturn represents the masses and the poor people. And it is time for us to support the poor people and underprivileged. Then Saturn will give a benefic influence in our charts. Also, this retrograde Saturn will especially influence people who are going through Sade Sati and Ashtam Shani and Dhaiya, right? So Sagittarius Rashi or Sagittarius moon sign people, Capricorn moon sign people and Aquarius moon sign people are especially influencing Sade Sati, and this influence of retrograde Saturn and Sade Sati together will have a huge impact in your life, and the decisions which you shall be taking right now in this period are going to echo throughout your life. So be very wise and be very just in making the right decisions. Don't do anything which is not correct. Bend your ways. For Gemini ascendant or Gemini moon sign, Saturn in the 8th house, already you are going through Ashtam Shani, which is a mentally excruciating period, and the effect of retrograde Saturn is going to increase. And the only way to bail yourself out from the harsh influence of Saturn is by mending your ways, becoming right, becoming honest, truthful, just and dutiful, and do your karma properly. If you do your karma properly, if you're honest and truthful, then whatever the negative influence Saturn is putting in your chart or in your horoscope, your birth chart, you will slowly, slowly bail out yourself, because Saturn likes people who correct their ways, who realize their mistakes, and who walk on the path of righteousness. Now, there is another problem, because Mars is about to get debilitated, right? And there is going to be a Saturn-Mars opposition, where Mars is in the 4th house in the sign of Cancer and Saturn is about to be in the 10th house in the sign of Capricorn and retrograde. So this situation happened back in 1962, Indo-China war. So it is very important and pertinent for the ministers and the higher authorities to take the right decision, not take any wrong decision, and not fuel anything which shall create war, because a retrograde Saturn and a debilitated Mars in opposition to each other can create warlike situation. Now for Aries ascendant or Aries moon sign people, this Saturn is placed in the 10th house, and it is a lot of the 10th house and 11th house. The 10th house is the house of karma and justice and duty, and the 11th house is the house of incoming gains. So the Aries ascendant people need to be very careful about their reputation, about the work that they are doing, and they need to be very just and dedicated towards their work. They need to look back, retrospect, and find out what is the mistakes that they have done during this period, and correct them and take precautionary measures such that Saturn doesn't give a negative influence in their lives. For Taurus ascendant, Saturn is transiting in the 9th house in the sign of Capricorn, and the 9th house is the house of spirituality, religion, guru, teachers, research, higher education and teaching. So you need to be very cautious, and you need to be very just and dutiful regarding your teachers, your gurus, your higher education. And if you are planning to do any spiritual journey, then this is not the right time to do that, because already there is this COVID situation, and moreover Saturn getting retrograde, so it will become worrisome and it will become troublesome if you make a long distance journey. So hold your spiritual voyages and long distance journey for some time. For Gemini ascendant and Gemini moon sign, Saturn is transiting in the 8th house. Now the 8th house is the house of your in-laws, the 8th house is the house of your secret research, occult science, tantra, mantra, mysticism. The 8th house is the savings of your wife. So you need to be very justful, and you need to be very careful in doing karma regarding the significance of the 8th house, because Saturn is already in Capricorn in its own sign and retrograde. So if you do anything wrong, if you try to take money from your wife's saving, if you misbehave with your in-laws, and if you do some tantra, mantra and occult work to harm someone, then it will give a disastrous effect in your life. So be cautious, Gemini ascendant and Gemini moon sign people. For Cancer ascendant, Saturn is exactly opposite in the 7th house in the sign of Capricorn. Now 7th house is the house of your life partner, your business partner, the dealings and negotiations that you do, the contracts and agreements that you sign, and also it is the house of business where you do trading with people. So whatever I have mentioned earlier, you have to be very careful while doing partnership, while dealing with your spouse, while signing contracts. You need to actually think several times before getting into any commitment, because this retrograde Saturn in the 7th house wants you to be truthful and just and correct regarding the significances of the 7th house. For Leo ascendant, Saturn is transiting through your 6th house in the sign of Capricorn. Now 6th house is the house of diseases, 6th house is the house of enemies, 6th house is the house of debts, that is the loans which you have taken, 6th house is the house of your pets, 6th house is also the house of your court cases. So you have to become very careful and aware about the significance of the 6th house. You need to be very careful while dealing with your pets, you need to be very careful while dealing with your court cases. You have to take away all the fraud cases that you have put in court, because if you have done something wrong and you think with the help of money you will actually win over the case, then Saturn will teach you a lesson, and Saturn will tell you that no, my brother or my sister, money is not everything, and you have put a fraud case upon somebody and you've troubled a poor or a needy person, and here you go, this is the punishment. Sixth house being the house of disease, you have to take care of your health a lot, because if you are not careful about the decisions that you make regarding your health, especially your digestive system, then you shall be facing problems of the digestive system in this 141 days. So beware. For Virgo ascendant, Saturn is transiting in the 5th house. Now 5th house is the house of romance, creativity, stage performance, dynamism, acting, politics, theater, childbirth. So Saturn getting retrograde in the 5th house warns you that be very, very careful and be very alert in the matters of the 5th house. If you are planning for a childbirth, then don't do something which is beyond the social norms or which is not in sync with ethics, because few people go to extreme limits to get a child. They do wrong things to get a child also. Don't do. For example, you are torturing your wife that you are not able to give me a baby or a son, and if you don't do that, then I will go away to someone. Then this Saturn will punish you and teach you a lesson, right? If you are a politician, if you are a Virgo ascendant and a politician, then you need to be very careful regarding the decisions that you make. You have to be very careful regarding the things that you promise to the people, because if you don't do it, then this Saturn will take you to task. If you are an actor, if you are a stage performer, if you are an artist, then this Saturn in the fifth house wants you that whatever roles that you are doing or whatever work you are doing, whatever creativity you are doing, that has to be ethical. And if you do any unethical work, then you will be taken to task. For Libra ascendant, Saturn is transiting through the fourth house in the sign of Capricorn. Now, fourth house is the house of your property, assets, vehicles, land, buildings, mother, comforts, and everything. So this Saturn is warning you that you have to be careful regarding the health of your mother. You have to make all the paperwork of your property right, because you are not paying your taxes properly and you are not maintaining the property properly. So this will be the time when your property, which is old and not maintained, can collapse. You have to be very careful about your comforts. You should not do something which will take you outside comfort zone, because this 141 days of retrogression of Saturn will test you in a way which you can't imagine. So be careful regarding the decisions and significance of the fourth house. For Scorpio ascendant, Saturn is transiting through the third house. Third house is the house of your relatives, your cousins. It is the house of communication, short distance journey, news, mass media, anchoring, radio. This is the third house. So all the people who are Scorpio ascendant and involved in the media, in the communication field, beware, don't spread wrong news. Because if you try to make money by creating news, then this Saturn, which is getting retrograde, will take you to task and you will get exposed. You have to also be very careful with your younger brother or younger siblings. You have to be careful in dealing with your cousins. And also, you have to be careful while doing short distance travel, because during this time, a retrograde Saturn will put you through situations that are filled with anxiety, tension, and nervousness. So beware. For Sagittarius ascendant, Saturn is transiting through the second house. The second house is the house of wealth, stocks, hoarded wealth, jewels, jewelry, family value, bank balance. The second house is also the house of your lineage. So you have to be very careful regarding your savings. You have to be very careful regarding the stocks and shares in which you are investing money. You have to safeguard your jewels, gems, and jewelry, because a retrograde Saturn will create a tension situation in your house. There will be chances where these things get stolen or something, so you have to be very careful. And you have to also take a wise decision. You have to revisit your bank accounts. You have to revisit the jewels and jewelry and whatever you have, the stocks and shares that you have bought, and you have to take the right decisions, because there will be fluctuations in aspects of these things and you need to be very careful. Capricorn ascendant, Saturn is transiting through the first house. Now, the first house is the house of your personality, your health, your vitality, your dynamism, how you appear in front of people, who you are as a person, how you're recognized. And this Saturn getting retrograde in Capricorn will actually put you into dilemma that, is this the right way that I should be going in front of people as whoever you are? Is this the right way to present yourself in front of people? Am I taking the right decision when it comes to my health and vitality and my personality? Am I making the right choices regarding the clothes and regarding the overall appearance of mine? So you will go through a inner dilemma about your appearance and your physical attributes, and because of that, you shall go through a period of anxiety and frustration for 141 days. For Aquarius ascendant, Saturn being your Lagna Lord is transiting through the 12th house. So it is my advice to you people, stay indoors, stay inside, because COVID-19 is going and already there is a lockdown. And the 12th house is the house of unknown. 12th house is the place where nobody can see you. It is the house of export and import. It is the house of jail, rehabilitation center, hospitals. So all the Aquarius ascendants, it is time for you to stay indoors and not come out in public and reveal yourself, because Saturn is transiting through the 12th house. So this is a time where it will be a lot of imagination and stuff. You have to imagine a lot of things during this time regarding your future. You will also be thinking about settling somewhere in a foreign country, but this is not the right time because Saturn is retrograde for 141 days. And if you think about going somewhere and settling somewhere, then it will take you through troubled and confusive tides. So don't sail abroad during this time. And remember, take this advice, stay indoors. Don't come into public visibility because Saturn wants you to be in the 12th house. Be in the 12th house, be in the 12th house. Don't come out. For Pisces ascendant, Saturn is transiting through the 11th house. The 11th house is the house of incoming gains. The 11th house is the house of your elder siblings. The 11th house is the house of your network circle. The 11th house is all the NGO and the social and religious, all the non-for-profit activities that is done. So those people, those Pisces ascendants who are involved in maintaining a network circle, who are involved in NGO and philanthropic activities, it is time for you to actually revisit and think, are you making the right decision? Are you making the right choices in regard to your community building, in regard to your elder siblings, in regard to your network circle, and in regard to the sources of income that you have in your life? You need to make amendments in them and you need to find out what are the faults and you need to nullify the problems. So this is my analysis about retrograde Saturn from 23rd May till 11th of October. And globally, it is going to be a period filled with frustration, tension and anxiety because Saturn in Capricorn and retrograde. And moreover, there is a pandemic which is going on. So things are going to be different. Saturn is going to take its hammer and hit on the head of everybody who are lying, who are cheating, who are unjustful, who are unlawful, and who are not doing their duties properly. So that's it for today, guys. This is Purab signing off from Purab's Astrology. Adios. I love you all. Jai Hind. Jai Bharat. ओम नीलांजन समाभासम रवि पुत्रम यमाग्रजम छाया मार्तंड संभूतम तम नमामि सनेश्चरम चैंट दिस मंत्र ऑफ शनि देव इट विल हेल्प यू बाय